Hey guys, I'm the Sky Spire, and welcome back to my Let's Play of Pikmin 2. Last time, we completed the Frontier Cavern in the Valley of Repose, and today, we are going to head back to the Valley of Repose to complete the very last area, complete what is left to be done in this first area of the Planet of the Pikmin. So we're going to start out over here. I just came back from watching a couple of videos from Pikmin 1. It's been pretty fun. I'm going to start out by taking out all of my red Pikmin, because we are going to be, yes, we did have a big red Pikmin massacre last time, but hopefully let's see if we can be a bit more careful. I would like to take out 15 whites, okay, I'd like to take out 15 whites, yes, and I'd like to take out 15 yellows, okay. Now, we have 85 Pikmin on the field. I would like to have 100, meaning I want to have a bunch of I believe it's 70 reds. I want to have a full arsenal of reds, but the thing is, yeah, we did have a pretty bad encounter with red, pretty bad thing going on with red Pikmin last time. So hopefully what I'm gonna be doing in this episode is hopefully building up our red Pikmin numbers, and let's get one more red Pikmin on there, okay. And, yeah, so hopefully we're going to be building up our red Pikmin numbers, and hopefully we're just going to be building ourselves up to prepare for the final dungeon in this area, the subterranean complex. And, oh my god, look at all these red leaves. There's a bit of, nectar above the, above our base, so we can take care of, use that to, for the reds. Okay. Are there any enemies here? Okay, we have a fire blowhog here. Okay, fitting, since we're trying to take care- Oh my god, no! Ideally, you might not want to throw them into the water. Did you oh my god, you're a jerk, man. You're just a jerk. Okay, you know what? It was only two Pikmin, so I'm fine with that, but hey, you know what? You're gonna pay. You're gonna pay. Okay, okay. All you guys, really? There's one, okay. Alright, so, I think, yeah, let's just have our red Pikmin get all this too. Come on. Alright, it's looking good. And, oh god, no, weird fish thing, no. Actually, I think that's good by itself, actually. I think that alone might just get us to 100. Should have probably had Louis stick around at the base, but nah, it's fine. Did the Peloposi sprout yet? No, they haven't. Alright. Well, let's do this. Let's get our new reds. We're 86 now. Yeah, that was pretty dumb to fight that fire blowhog without considering the direction it was facing. But hey, then again, I don't know. It was just weird. Where are you guys? Oh, okay. Yeah, I guess that was pretty far. Okay, so I'm gonna take some reds and I'll just come up here. I'm just gonna throw them on because I do not want one of these three to have the bugs. Do not have the bugs, please. Look, I'm looking away, actually. Okay, there we go. Okay, what do we have here? Do not have the bugs. Okay, we have the nectar. Do not have the bugs. Okay, that's good. That's good! Okay, I'm sorry. I just wanted to be very cautious. Just wanted to be cautious about that. Sure, let's take advantage of it again. It's really fun doing this, man. I'm not like some corrupt captain always taking advantage of every single glitch I can. Hey, if you were a captain and you- Oh, damn it! Did I actually get it? No, I didn't. Yeah, that was really bad. But if you were a captain and you found a way to double the amount of supplies you had, would you take advantage of it? I would. I sure as heck would. Alright, let's see here. I think, oh gosh, Mr. Sensor Bar. Ooh, spin it in circles. Alright, so I think, come on guys. Alright. How many Pikmin is that? That's 97. I'm good with that. I'm good with 97. We don't need to go in there with exactly 100. 3 Pikmin isn't exactly going to make a life-changing difference, now will it? So, I think with our 97, unless there are Peloposes right here, are there? Okay, no. So, we should have 67 reds, 15 yellows, and 15 whites. I think that's a pretty good number to go into this next dungeon with. This next dungeon, the subterranean complex, Oh, what the heck, no, I made nectar appear and then I didn't take it. Please don't tell me nectar despawns. Something tells me it does. Well, it's still there, so let's take care of it. Come on, all these red leaves, man. I mean, we're still gonna have some, but, oh, come on, Louis. Alright, come on. Alright, come on. That Luigi voice hit from Dark Moon. Come in. Alright. That makes me smile. It makes me smile. Alright, so... heading off from base, let's head out to the complete other end of the Valley of Repose. Also, I am trying to do a lot of binge recording. What the heck are you guys doing? Okay. I am trying to do quite a bit of binge recording these days, or rather, these last couple of episodes, because the thing is, I do have a deadline. I do actually have a pretty crazy deadline for completing this Let's Play, and I don't want it to stress it too much, because that makes it seem like I'm doing this Let's Play just to complete it, which isn't even close to the case. Pikmin 2 is a legitimately fun game. All of the Pikmin games are. I don't know, it's just that there is a deadline that I have for completing it because of Xenoblade Chronicles X, which, as a lot of you guys probably know, I'm going to be doing a Let's Play of that game. What the heck is that? Oh, duh, I'm stupid, that's where we're going. Alright, so, we're gonna wanna head over here, and we're gonna head around here, and we're gonna go over to one of my personal favorite dungeons in this game. I really, really like this cave right here. We've already went through the introductions, but we never actually went into it. We still have half of the day, but I mean, hey, what are we gonna do with it, right? Just harvest Pikmin that we lose in this place. The Subterranean Complex. Let's begin. Alright, so, we have our reds, yellows, and whites, and only dangers we could see here were fire, electricity, and poison, so I think we're pretty well equipped for the Subterranean Complex. This is going to be the longest dungeon we have experienced yet. This is going to be pretty interesting. I think we'll have a fun time with this dungeon. I do think we will. I really do like it. I don't have, like, very clear memory of it. I do have clear memory of the boss. My gosh, let's just say the boss of this dungeon is definitely this dungeon's magnum opus. No! Let's try not to do that. I think I tossed a whale on my way, Pikmin. I think I did. Oh, yeah, okay. Wow, we just landed in this little secluded area off to the side. Fine. Let's do this. Just carry this guy back. And I don't think there's anything off in the corner. Yeah, okay. I wasn't expecting anything. Is that Ultra Bitter Spray? Looks like it. Oh, damn it. Okay, well, hey! I'm not doing the glitch anymore. Hope you guys are happy. I mean, I think you guys will support me on this. Come on, I mean, hey, it's not even exactly game break. I know I bring this up every single time I do the glitch, but it's not exactly game breaking, and it's fun, you know? Alright, so let's see. And it's easy to do as well. It's very easy to do. Alright, so let's see here. Let's get our whites and take care of the poison. This is going to be a pretty big battle we have ahead of ourselves, unless we can... Did he actually just, like, get confused as to where we were? Come on, squash him. Okay. Oh, no. No. Come on. Okay, we're gonna have to start a fight here. We're starting a fight here. Okay, maybe not. Ooh, okay. That went very well. Hey, wake up. Actually, don't. What do we have here? Oh, God. Okay, we have this version of, Snitch Bug. Let's see. How can we deal with it? Gosh, this is a big sub-level to start off. Whoa, there's more over there? Can we, oh, okay, it's just a dead end. Okay, I was just wondering. This is an interesting sub-level. Okay, well, I think, I'll have, good thing we're both at full health, so we don't have to worry about health like we did in the Frontier. Oh, my God, come on, guys. So after... I trust you know your cunnis. I know I brought this up one time, and I just brought this up as a complete joke, but what if Pikmin actually were colorblind? That would be pretty interesting, considering the fact that, you know, I mean, yes, it's kind of like Pokemon, where, like, the Pikmin do trust their captains, plus having a ridiculously similar amount of continents in general, but oh my gosh, okay, at least we killed that hairy bulb before he killed us. How many else do we have? 13. Okay, wait, we only lost two? I'm cool with that. Oh, duh. Yes, the whites. Okay, then we'll just take care of this. Whoa! Okay. What the heck? You're alive? Come on, dude. Your mama is dead. Alright. I think the whole idea of... But back to the whole idea of Pokemon. I was saying, Whoa! Did I just wrangle him down to the ground? That's what it looked like. I mean, that's not what actually happened, but that's sure as heck what it looked like. Anyway, it's kind of like Pokemon where, yeah, the Pokemon, yes, they can fight on their own, but for the most part, like, if we're going to use anime logic, they really do trust their trainer. And Pikmin definitely trust their captain. I mean, look, you're whistling them all over the place. You're definitely ordering them around what to do, for you're their captain, the captain of this really big, you know, force to just scavenge for survival. What would they do without you, honestly? Probably just run into a pool of water and cause extinction. But the thing is, it's also interesting thinking of whether they're colorblind or not. And I feel like there is more evidence to this rather than just saying, hey, they might be colorblind because they can't follow orders. In fact, that probably is the case. I just think it's an interesting idea. I don't have any evidence to prove it. But it's a fun idea, thinking, what if the Pikmin actually are colorblind? Considering what? They're carrots. Come on, dude. Do you expect them to be the most evolved of species? Oh, crap. It'd be nice if you could, like, come over here. Come on. Come on. Not worrying about this, all these Pikmin. Oh, damn it. Gosh, they're really good at getting these captains, man. Okay, come on. Either that or I'm just bad at avoiding them. Okay, come on. Come on. There we go. Swarm them. Swarm them. Fall on the ground. Swarm them. And you're done. Okay. Let's get this hairy bulb orb next. Let's get our reds. These fine fighters. Reds do, I believe, 1.5 damage to enemies, so it's really good fight. What the heck? How'd you eat reds? How did you eat that? Okay, whatever, whatever. Where is our treasure? Oh, isn't it a birdie treasure? I think, the treasure is, like, right here and it's buried or something. Oh. What? Didn't we already get a roll of gamma tape? There was a buried treasure on this floor. I know that. Oh, I know. It's, hold on. Yeah. It's right here is the buried treasure. Okay, Olimar. Hey, buddy. Just come up here. What the heck are you guys doing? Come on. All right. There's the exit. So, yeah, this isn't going to be too hard. This first level. But, hey, whites. Whitey tidies. Tidy whiteys. Get around here and... Alright, awesome. And, we can just disband them and they'll overcome it, I think. Yeah, that's awesome. Alright, so... Wow, we actually cleared this floor rather easily. Have they brought it back yet? Okay, get in there. Give it time. I was really confused, because we got a roll of gamma tape earlier. I was like, did I, like, not get in? It just warped to the other end of the world? Boogie. Okay, let's see. What do we got? Plump. Alright. Exhausted Super Stick. Okay, the other one was called the something else Super Stick. So good to know it's not a glitch, and it's not the same thing, and... I don't think that's even possible to have that kind of glitch happen. Anyway. Let's see. Oh, wow. Excuse that, please. Alright. It sounded like I was getting really far away from my mic, didn't it? Alright, I actually was getting really far away from my mic. I was like sitting up and sitting really far away, so I decided to get closer. We have a rotary phone? Nouveau table. I'm sorry, it took me saying it out loud 3 times to actually get the joke. That was pretty good. That was pretty funny, actually. Nouveau table. Alright. How would that... Okay. Would somebody, like, rip out a rotary phone? Like, did one of these bulbs, like, chew out the dial pad of a rotary phone and then just, like, consume their grub on it or something? I don't know. That's a hilarious thought, though. Alright, so that's pretty much it. Let's head down further. Gosh, I'm really looking forward to the lower levels of this place. Wow, first time I coughed in a while. Alright, that's a good sign. Getting better by I like to think that, like, using my throat a lot more is kind of clearing it out, you know? Alright, let's see here. What do we got? Alright, we got an egg. Oh, okay. This sub-level, interesting thing I want to know. I think we had a sub-level like this in the White Flower Garden as well. But, these sub-levels were just, like, this open platform in the middle of space. If you toss Pikmin out into the abyss, like, they will die. Like, captains have no way of getting thrown out there, but Pikmin, yeah, they can- Oh, come on! Hate these things. Such a freaking jump scare as well, man. Okay, that one Pikmin. Alright. Oh! Here's the careening dirigibug. Okay, these guys will legitimately just pull out a bomb rock and toss it out, which will then explode. And they're so weird. I mean, they're very hard to deal with, honestly, and especially in this kind of floor. I don't even know if I should do. Oh, crap. This is interesting. Okay, there's a ton of these guys. Is this the treasure? This is the treasure. Okay, how are we gonna go about this? I think we might even just... Can we just, like, carry this past them? Okay, yeah. We can just carry this past them. And the bomb rocks won't have time to explode. We'll already have passed by them. So, okay, that actually works pretty well. And is that the only treasure on this sub-level? That'd be great if it was, because... Whoa, no. I think those Pikmin made it past before it exploded? Gear. Spirit Flogger. Something I want to bring up is, no, there's more. Oh, crap. Did somebody die? No. Okay, I thought I heard a pain Pikmin sound, and that could only be from explosion, but I thought explosions were instant death, so... Hey. What was that? Hey! I feel like it's buried treasure somewhere. Oh no, 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 no. Oh my god, no! Freaking leaf Pikmin. Damn, do not tackle that stupid thing. Okay, we have a light bulb? I think you can tell the theme of the subterranean complex being sort of old mechanics. Like, whoa. God, these guys look cool. They look like Metroid enemies. Speaking of Metroid, and speaking of old mechanics, any of you know the, Skytown Alesia from Metroid Prime 3? That's my favorite Metroid area. I was blown away by that, because I just want to say the, I don't know how to describe it. There's a word to describe it. And if any of you watched that movie Hugo, I watched that a couple of years back. Wow, I barely remember that. Network Mainbrain. Isn't that just a light bulb? Anyway, then again, I guess that could, work. So both the movie Hugo and Skytown Alesia from Metroid Prime 3 had this theme. And what it was kind of technology, but like tin technology. Not like metal and platinum and what we use today. No, kind of like copper and tin, you know? Like those like old clockwork style stuff, you know? Alright, so let me just say this right now. I actually don't know where I was in my conversation when I first went to sub-level 3. I'm redoing sub-level 3, guys, because let's just say I made a very retarded mistake when I did sub-level 3 once. You're gonna hang out up there, really? No! So, I'm gonna redo sub-level 3. I already did the sub-level, but I'm just gonna redo it. I think I just got a harder template. Come on. Whoa! Oh, come on! Whoa! Okay, so he destroyed a fire geyser. I'm okay with that. I'm cool with that. But yeah. So basically the whole deal was, I don't know if I already said this in sub-level 2, or if I said it in that failed recording, or not failed recording, but stupid recording of sub-level 3. I don't know. But anyway. So, the whole deal was, Hugo was in charge of the- Let's try not to throw Pikmin over the edge. Hugo was in charge of the train station, even though nobody really knew that. Charge of the train station. He was in charge of the clocks, and, the whole deal with that was, I mean, the clocks in that movie, and really just the entire theme of that movie, was very, I mean, the technology wasn't all metal and, you know, like, it wasn't, like, all like the kind of metal that we have today. Rather, it was, you know, tin and copper, like we have today, like this, like, sort of, this color on the ground. So, because of that, I mean, it just gives that really ancient technology feel, you know, like, not Victorian style. I don't know how to describe it in words. My other example of this is Skytown Alesia, where they had, it was very tin-like. There were even these sort of tin robots, super strong stabilizer. It's ironic, I actually pulled a nail out of my school desk on Friday. Anyway, oh god, make it sound like I'm some monster who rips nails out of everything. No. In Skytown Alesia, there were, like, these tin bots that would, like, walk at you like clockwork soldiers. And, I mean, it's just a very nice, ancient feel. Now, I wanted to talk about this because, The theme of the... Oh, hey! Let's see if we can, sure, let's see if we can do it. Let's just, disband these guys to take care of... Are you gonna do it? Or, yeah, they will. Awesome. Okay. Louis? Alright. Push Olimar in there. Oh god, this looks gonna look so weird. But yeah, it had all these tin robots, and it had this ancient machinery. And the reason I'm bringing up the sort of theme slash machinery from Metroid Prime 3 and Hugo is look at the theme of the subterranean complex. That is what the theme of this place is. It's like all of these little candles looking up. It's and look at what we're getting. We're getting these like coils and nails and stuff. We're getting that kind of stuff. Coiled launcher. Wait, hold on. Wait, no, other way. Somebody make a gif of that. Yeah, buddy. Alright, so, let's see here, that's hypnotizing, right there. Oh, let me do, my name, please! Wow, he actually fired a boulder behind me, that was terrifying. Let's see, okay, are we back together, there's a big bag family? Big bag family. Let's see here. Whoa, did I already lose more than, didn't I come in this cave with 97 Pikmin? I have 85, and I'm only on sub-level 3. That is not a good sign. Oh, good. We took care of him before he could fire anything. And we have an ivory candy pup, in case... Wait, how many Pikmin of each kind do we have? You came in here with so many more red Pikmin? Okay, good thing we didn't lose the other kinds, because... because they're pretty valuable to us as well. Oh, there's our last treasure over there. So, yeah, I just wanted to bring that up. I am a pretty big fan of that sort of style, you know? Alright, let's see here. Let's toss these guys on. Oh no, 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 no! Well, you're a d- I'm sorry. That was online. But, oh my god, that made me mad. Did you really have to toss him all off the edge? God, I'm sorry, I don't- No, come on! Get back here. Oh, yeah, he's with me. Awesome. Oh my god. I'm sorry, I don't usually curse on my channel, but oh my god. On my Collab channel, my partner in crime usually does it, but I usually try to keep it down, and oh god dang it. God, I don't curse that much. Anyway, what do we have here? Oh, okay. No, whoa! Lick all of the fire. Lick it all. Lick all of it. Oh my god. I'm being very careful now, are we? Okay, I think that's it for this sub-level, though. Gosh, we're not doing good. We came in here with 97. We're here with 81 now. Come on, we're only 3 sub-levels in. Come on, come on, come on. We're not gonna be... come on. We need to keep up a good pace if you wanna pass out. Look at this. We, like, run past one of them, and they, like, kind of turn off. They're very weak. Look at all these lights. Gosh. I really do like the subterranean complex, and I know I mentioned that already. Omega Flywheel. But just look at the theme of the treasures, look at the theme of just the dungeon layouts, it's just such a cool idea for a dungeon, not to mention the fact that, again, if we're gonna bring up the theory of this being a version of Earth, let's just leave these guys here, if this is a version of Earth, then this is such an interesting idea, like people like buried them underground or something, I would be perfectly fine just spending a long period of time, just debating Pikmin theories as to, like, maybe the past of Pikmin. They're never going to explicitly say the past. No, not at all. But they're going to bring up interesting creatures which you can talk about theories about. Like, the Umibozu in Pikmin 3, that theory. I'm not going to talk about it in detail because I'm going to Let's Play Pikmin 3 sometime in the future. Hopefully. Most definitely. The Umibozu theory is... It's pretty decent, I suppose. But, I mean... It's just open for so many theories. Whoa! Was it just me, or could I see sub-level 5 underneath sub-level 4? Hold on, let's, Okay. Dude! Excuse me, that looks so freaking cool! It's like all these... Oh my god! That looks so awesome! All these pillars. Okay, hold on, guys. Why are you suddenly not in my command? Come on. Suck this up. And do we have all flowers now? Do we have all flowers? No, we have all flowers. That's awesome. All right, let's see. There's our... Oh, we can exit from the cave if we want to. That's awesome. Where are we going? Oh! We actually haven't had one of these. This is like a relaxing stage, like where you can just relax. Just come in and just, hey, chill out. If you want to... This is like a break stage, you know? Like, hey, you don't... If you just want to get some nectar, get some candy pop buds, just... You know, hang out and relax. This is kind of one of those floors, and I like that. I like that a lot. Just the fact that they have this, just hang out. Let's just hang out for a bit. Alright, that's pretty good. Alright, you also have the option to turn Pikmin into white Pikmin. But I think we haven't even lost any white Pikmin in here, and we have lost reds. I do not want to have to sacrifice more reds for whites. I think we'll be fine. And there's no treasure here either, right? Yeah, there's no treasure on the sub-level. Alright, so let's head deeper down into the subterranean complex. Alright, I think I might do one more sub-level and then I'll end this video. I'll end this episode off, because we're approaching that limit. The good old limit. Sub-level 5! Alright, let's see what we have here. This looks interesting. This reminds me of one of the last levels of Super Monkey Ball, Banana Blitz. I know, that is the literal last thing. I forgot that game existed. I forgot the Super Monkey Ball games existed. Oh, no! Okay. I do not want these dream holes! Okay, yeah, we're dealing with suicide bomber dweevils. Oh, come on! Come on, I do not want to be surrounded by bombs! Okay. So yeah, these are dweevils. I think these dweevils are called volatile dweevils. What these guys do is they will... Oh, come on! I'm sorry, but this is... Oh, dweevils. Come on, calm down. Just chased by bombs. Okay, I actually think it's a really smart idea to walk down this path first before taking the treasure, because otherwise, what's gonna fall on my head? Nothing. Okay, good. Because otherwise, you would have to deal with all the dweebles, and you would have to deal with all the bombs. Come on, no need to deal with that. No need to deal with that, guys. Whoa! Do you see that red just getting knocked back by the explosion? Dude, he died like the most epic slow motion death. Oh crap. Do you have to go up this route? Wait, stop moving. Oh damn it! No, oh, get out. Do you have to go up this route? I hope you'll go up this route. Yeah, that's the quicker route. Okay, please don't tell me you're going to activate these bombs somehow. Oh god, this stupid red. Really? I'm sorry, I sound so angry. I'm just under so much stress. Ugh, all these bombs. Just so much instant death. All of the instant death hazards. This is a legitimately really cool looking sub-level though. I like it. With all these very weak little sources of light everywhere. Yeah, all these slopes. Really cool. What do we have here? Whoa! The mystical disc. Look at that. Alright. I just dropped my weird mode. Now I can't find it. Alright, there it is. Alright. And there's more. Oh, I see it. I kind of want to throw my Pikmin down there. At the same time, though, that's not very smart for multiple reasons. I mean, I want to. I really do want to. You can throw your Pikmin in a lot of places, actually. You know, just for the lulz, let's throw a red over there. I feel like there could be a lot of speedrunning tactics, in the game there could be a lot of speedrunning tactics. If any of you know, Miles SMB, I'm actually a pretty big fan of his speedruns. I've been looking at his speedruns for a long time. Did that disappear from a cloud in the sky? And, I mean, he's amazing. He's a really great speedrunner. I mean, there's a lot of really nice speedrunners out there. Oh, no! Okay, good. There's these guys, and then of course there's the amazing Punch-Out speedrunners, like Zalad One, Sinister. And Sinister even competed in the Nintendo World Championships. Like, I immediately recognized Sinister. Sinister One, I believe his name is, but yeah. Let's see here. But Miles SMB, I know he does a bunch of Pikmin speedruns. And, like, I just saw a couple of them, just ways to exploit the game. It's just pretty fun. I really like him as a guy, just as a speedrunner as well. Anyway, I think... Anyway, I can just imagine, from the top of there, just throw Pikmin around, and just say, come to Spee, and then just, like, everybody comes to you. Anyway, yes, I referenced that, out of all things. Come on. Get over here. Alright. Alright. Alright, so I think, gosh, all of this really ancient clockwork looking things. The Adamantine Girdle. Alright guys, so I think that's gonna be it for today. We actually lost quite a few Pikmin. But next time, we're gonna be heading down further down the subterranean complex, hopefully reaching the bottom. I think now you guys realize why this cave is one of my personal favorites. Just for all of the different themes that surround this place. It's really interesting. And next time we're going to be delving further down. So anyway, make sure, as always, to like, comment, and subscribe for more on Pikmin and all other things Nintendo. I'm the Sky Spire, and until then...